different organisms. We discussed about the heart. So we will start with the heart now. Heart is located at thoracic cavity. It is somewhat tilted towards the left, and in your NCERT it is given that one's heart is opposite one's clenched fist. So heart is our pumping organ or our pump. See, heart has the mesodermal origin. It is situated in the thoracic cavity and it is opposite the clenched fist. So in case of different organisms like Pisces, amphibians, reptiles, apes, mammals, the heart is a different chamber. So we will start with the Pisces. You can remember it with the name Param. P-E-R-A-M. So if we will go first with P. P stands for Pisces, A stands for amphibians, R for reptiles, A for apes, and M for mammals. So in case of Pisces, Pisces are fishes. Pisces, the heart is of two chambers only. Means one auricle or atrium is there, and second one ventricle is there. Means in case of Pisces, Pisces live in water. Pisces, amphibians, both are the habitat of water. Whether reptiles are of land and apes and mammals are also the land. So these are the terrestrial organisms and these two are the aquatic organisms. But amphibians are not completely aquatic organisms. Some more part of the life cycle of amphibians is in the aquatic system. Otherwise, the next half is in the land, or these are of terrestrial means. They have both the life cycles, means up to pupal stage or the larval stage, they are living in the water, and rest part of the life is spent on the land. Hence, they have both the habitats, aquatic as well as terrestrial. So in case of Pisces, the two chambered heart is there. One is one auricle and one ventricle. You can also call as atrium the auricle. Auricle as well as atrium, you can use any of it, either auricle or atrium. So first, in case of Pisces, the heart will having the deoxygenated blood. This heart will pass on the deoxygenated blood to the gills, where the gills are the respiratory organs of the Pisces. Where this blood is going to be oxygenated, means now oxygen will add to the blood in the gills. Now gills will pass it to the body and to all the body parts. Now the oxygenated blood is raised. Now this oxygen is utilized by the body parts, and now the blood will become deoxygenated. Now this deoxygenated blood will return back to the heart, means they will follow this one pathway only. Hence here the single circulation of blood is occurring. Now next is amphibians and reptiles. Both these organisms have three chambered heart, means two auricles or atrium are there, whether one ventricle is there. But there is an exception, that is crocodile, which has four chambered heart. In case of amphibians and reptiles, two auricles and one ventricle is there. Left auricle, students, which side is the left auricle? This side. Okay, left auricle is having the oxygenated blood, right auricle will have the deoxygenated blood. Means this side is the oxygenated blood and this side is the deoxygenated blood. Both these bloods will go to the single ventricle, and a little bit of mixing of the blood, means oxygenated blood and deoxygenated blood, both will get mixed up in the single ventricle. Hence, these organisms can tolerate the mixing of deoxygenated and oxygenated blood, because these organisms can tolerate the mixing of blood, because these utilize a very less amount of energy for their life processes. While being us mammals or apes, which are warm-blooded organisms, utilize much energy in maintaining their body temperature, because we are the warm-blooded organism. Hence, we require a complete separation of oxygenated and deoxygenated blood. Hence, our heart is of four chambered. So, in case of amphibians and reptiles, the heart is of only three chambers. One auricle, left auricle having the oxygenated blood, right auricle having the deoxygenated blood, and both oxygenated as well as deoxygenated blood is going to mix up in a single ventricle. So from single ventricle, this blood will go to the different body organs and for the circulatory system. So here the circulatory system is of incomplete double circulation. Means double circulation is occurring there. Auricle se oxygenated blood aa raha hai, and right auricle economic circle and the ventricle. So the type of circulation is incomplete double circulation. In case of apes, apes are birds, and mammals, humans, like the heart is four chambered, means there are two separate auricles and ventricles are there. We have discussed about the diagram of the heart in your previous class, where we drew the right auricle, left auricle, right ventricle, left ventricle. So there are four chambered heart in case of apes and mammals. So this is a typical human heart diagram. Left auricle is having the oxygenated blood from the lungs with the help of these pulmonary veins. The oxygenated blood will come from the lungs, from the pulmonary vein, will enter into the left atrium, and from left atrium it will go to the left ventricle with the help of these valves, which are called as bicuspid valve. Okay. Similarly, the deoxygenated blood from the body, different body parts, will come from firstly the upper body parts from the superior vena cava, lower body parts from the inferior vena cava, and this deoxygenated blood will enter into the right auricle, and through right auricle this blood will go to the right ventricle with the help of tricuspid valve. So first we will discuss about this structure of the heart. Okay, heart is of four chamber. One is left atrium or left auricle, right atrium or right auricle. Both are separated with a septum. You can also call it as interatricular septum or interauricular septum. Septum here, and because I have drawn these arteries and aorta along with, so the bowl is somewhat little thick here, but this is not in the actual case. This is very thin. Okay. So the septum here is very thin because the blood volume in case of auricles is little bit less in comparison to the ventricles. The septum, which is passing through the left ventricle and right ventricle, is a little bit thick. Okay, so walls of septum are thin here in comparison to the ventricles. Okay, so left atrium and right atrium are both differentiated with the help of interauricular septums. Now, these both auricles have valves. What is the function of valves? Actually, valves prevent the backflow of the blood, because जो blood यहाँ से आया है left auricle से left ventricle में and right auricle से right ventricle में, वही blood वापस से ना चला जाए in the auricle and right auricle and left auricle, उसके लिए क्या होता है, यहाँ पे valves gate like structures present होते हैं जो कब खुलेंगे, जब blood को इधर से इधर आना होगा, transport होना होगा, otherwise they will be getting closed. Okay, so bicuspid valve and tricuspid valve are present. Why the name is bicuspid and tricuspid? Because there are two cusp-like muscle structures are present here and three cusp muscle-like structures present here. These cusp muscle-like structures, mean tricuspid valve and bicuspid valve, are attached with the help of chordae tendineae, these thread-like structures. Okay, these thread-like structures are here bound with the special kind of muscle that is called as papillary muscle. Okay, these papillary muscle attach these chordae tendineae with these valves, means tricuspid valve and bicuspid valve. What is the function of these chordae tendineae? Because once the blood will enter into the right ventricle or left ventricle, the blood volume will get raised. So it can also happen कि ब्लड वॉल्यूम बहुत ज्यादा हो गया, ब्लड अब क्या करेगा, बैकफ्लो करने की कोशिश करेगा, प्रेशर लगा सकता है, सो दैट ये वाल्व्स फिर से ओपन ना हो, क्योंकि रस्सी की तरह, डिफरेंट मीनिंग ऑफ द कॉर्ड इज रस्सी. ठीक है, तो ये कॉर्ड लाइक स्ट्रक्चर होते हैं, थ्रेड बंडल्स होते हैं थ्रेड्स के, एक रस्सी की तरह, तो ये इसको पकड़ के रखते हैं सो दैट ये वापस से खुल ना जाएंगे. तो वाल्व की जो क्लोजर है उसको मेंटेन करते हैं दिस कॉर्डे टेंडिने, एंड दिस आर अटैच्ड दिस एट दिस सबस्टेटम्स कॉल्ड पैपिलरी मसल्स. ओके, सो राइट एट्रियम में ब्लड आएगा विद द हेल्प ऑफ द सुपीरियर वेना कैवा एंड इंफीरियर वेना कैवा फ्रॉम डिफरेंट बॉडी ऑर्गन्स, एंड दिस ब्लड वुड बी डीऑक्सीजनेटेड. नाउ वी डिस्कस ड्यूरिंग आवर लास्ट लेक्चर दैट हार्ट हैज these special muscles, or heart is covered with a bag-like structure or double membranous muscle layer that is called as cardium. Okay? So the outermost covering of the heart is a single thin layer muscular structure that is called as epicardium. Then after epicardium, the innermost is endocardium. Endocardium and epicardium both are single thin layer, while the myocardium is a little bit thicker than the, both of these, epicardium and endocardium. So myocardium is thicker. You can see here, this is epicardium, this is a single layer. I have drawn it throughout the heart. This one is single layer to show you, and this one is also single thin layer, that is endocardium. Now this rest part is called myocardium. Now the myocardium lining has these muscular structures which have these contraction troughs and puffs here. These are called as trabeculae carnae. Okay, trabeculae carnae. Now the walls of these ventricles are thicker than the walls of atria. Why is this? Because I told you that the blood volume inside the atria is slightly lesser than the blood volume inside the ventricles. Hence, to maintain their blood volume, the walls of the ventricles are a little bit thicker. Okay. Now, coming to the arteries and veins. There are two types of blood vessels. One is artery and second one is vein. And third one you can also call as capillaries, but these are also the part of arteries itself. So what will happen, students, once the heart is filled with the blood which is going away from the heart, okay, towards the body organs, is happening with the help of what? Arteries. A for artery and A for away means those vessels which took blood away from the heart are called as artery, and those vessels which brings the blood to the heart back are called as veins. B for veins, and B for, you can remember it by the vapis khana. Means veins kya karte hain, vapis blood ko la rahe hain from the different body parts to the heart, and arteries kya kar rahi hain, blood ko away leke ja rahi hain heart se kahan, different body parts ke paas. But there is, all the arteries carry oxygenated blood while all the veins carry deoxygenated blood. Because deoxygenated blood ko kiske paas hai? Veins ke paas. Kyun? Kyunki wo kahan se wapas la rahi hai blood ko? Heart ke paas la rahi hai, from the body organs. To body organs ke paas se blood kya ho jata hai? Deoxygenated ho jata hai, aur wo wapas aayega with the help of veins to the heart. But there is an exception, that is pulmonary vein. Pulmonary word means related to the lung. So, jo vein lung se aayegi, that will have in the oxygenated blood. Because lungs mein kya ho raha hai? Oxygenation ho raha hai blood ka, purification ho raha hai blood ka. So, pulmonary vein will carry the oxygenated blood to the heart and will pour that oxygenated blood into the left atria or auricle. According to this, also the pulmonary artery is also an exception. It will carry deoxygenated blood. All the arteries will carry oxygenated blood, but the pulmonary artery is an exception. Pulmonary again is related to the lung. This will carry deoxygenated blood, and this blood will go to the lungs for purification. So, if we consider the heart as this diagram, so starting with the left auricle, okay, we will take right auricle first. The blood from different organs will come from inferior vena cava and superior vena cava into the right auricle. Now, from right auricle, this blood will go to the right ventricle, but until then, and same way, here the left auricle will get filled with the oxygenated blood from these pulmonary veins, and this blood will come from the lungs. So, it is occurring simultaneously. Oxygenated blood from the pulmonary veins to the left ventricle, deoxygenated blood from the different body organs to the right auricle from the superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. Superior means upar. So, upar ke jitne bhi body organs hain, like the brain, wahan se jo blood aa raha hai, wo with the help of superior vena cava aayega. Aur inferior means niche ke, yani ki jitne bhi body organs niche ke hain, wahan se jo blood aa raha hai, wo inferior vena cava se enter hoga inside the right atrium. So right atrium will have the deoxygenated blood only, while the left atrium or auricle will have the oxygenated blood. Now these valves are closed. Until and unless these left atrium and right atrium will be filled with the blood. Now the blood will pressure, put the pressure, and this blood pressure will help in the opening of these valves. So tricuspid valve and bicuspid valve will get open. Now the blood will pour into the right ventricle and left ventricle simultaneously. In the left ventricle, the oxygenated blood, and in the right ventricle, the deoxygenated blood. Okay? Then these valves will get closed so that this blood does not flow back to the atrium. Clear? Now, how this blood from right ventricle and left ventricle will go to the different body parts and the heart? These aorta and pulmonary artery will do that. See, this structure, this T-like structure is called as pulmonary artery, and this is having the opening here. Clear? Opening in the right ventricle. But this is also guarded with some wall. That wall is called as semilunar wall. As well, the aorta, this half S-like structure, is also guarded with the semilunar wall. Why the name is semilunar? Semi means half, lunar means moon. Because this has the half moon-like shape, a crescent moon-like shape. Hence, the name is called as semilunar wall. So, this deoxygenated blood from the right ventricle now, once the right ventricle and left ventricle will get filled with the proper blood volume, and bicuspid valve and tricuspid valve has been closed, now the blood will put pressure. ये फिल हो गए तो ब्लड में स्पेस नहीं है कहीं अब आगे कहाँ जाए तो ब्लड कहाँ जाएगा नाउ इट विल पुट प्रेशर ऑन दिस वॉल्स सो दिस सेमिलुनर वॉल्स विल गेट ओपन सो डीऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड फ्रॉम द राइट वेंट्रिकल एंड ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल नाउ विल एंटर इन द एओर्टा एंड पल्मोनरी आर्टरी क्लियर एओर्टा विल रिसीव द ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल and pulmonary artery will receive the deoxygenated blood from the right ventricle. Now, this aorta will distribute this oxygenated blood which has been taken from the left ventricle to all the body organs. Clear? To the brain, to the lower body organs, to the vital organs, all the body organs, and this blood is oxygenated blood. Whether this pulmonary artery, the opening of the pulmonary artery is towards the right ventricle. So, from the right ventricle, it will take the deoxygenated blood. The deoxygenated blood will go to the lungs for oxygenation with the help of pulmonary artery. Because pulmonary means lungs, so this artery will carry the deoxygenated blood from heart to the lungs. While the pulmonary vein will bring that oxygenated blood from the lungs to the heart. Clear? So, see, there are two organs involved. Means one is lung and second one is heart. But other body organs are also involved because the heart is supplying the oxygenated blood to the other body organs. Means we can say if the lung are involved, then this is the pulmonary circulation. So this pulmonary artery carrying the deoxygenated blood to the lung and oxygenated blood back from the lung by the pulmonary vein to the heart. So this will mark the pulmonary circulation. While there is the systemic circulation also. In case of systemic circulation, what is happening? The aorta is supplying the oxygenated blood to the rest of the body organs, and from rest of the body organs, this deoxygenated blood is collected with the help of veins, and these veins, blood vessels are veins, वापस लेके आएंगे deoxygenated blood from the different body organs. By the inferior vena cava and superior vena cava and pouring into the atrium. So this is the systematic circulation or systemic circulation. Hence, this is called as double circulation. Means the blood is flowing twice from the heart. Okay? Oxygenated blood and deoxygenated blood. Hence, in case of humans, the blood circulates as a double circulation. And we observe this double circulation as a complete circulation in case of apes and mammals. Apes are our birds and mammals including the humans. Because these two group of organisms are warm-blooded organisms. And hence warm-blooded organisms require much energy for their vital processes or different life processes. So to maintain their body temperature because they have to adjust their internal body temperature.